Hey guys, what's up? It's me, Pager, here once again with another American Horror Story Hotel review. This is for episode 11, entitled Battle Royale. So there will be spoilers in this episode, just to give you a heads up. If you're going to enjoy it, leave a like, leave any comments on what you thought of the episode, and subscribe if you are new. So the episode actually starts off with Iris and Liz loading their guns prior to the end of the last episode. If you remember, they went in shooting the whole penthouse up. So when they go to actually shoot up the penthouse, they shoot Elizabeth, but Donovan shields the majority of the bullets off her. She manages to get away pretty badly injured, but Donovan is left dying. So Iris actually drags Donovan out of the hotel so he doesn't die in there and isn't trapped for eternity. Straight after this, we see Elizabeth actually getting these bullets removed from her by Sally in a quite grotesque manner, might I say. Now, following this, we actually get a flashback to 1993, where we see Sally as this songwriter, but also a drug slinger as well, and we learn about why she has certain abandonment issues. So essentially, she gets obsessed with these two singers, and to keep it short, after getting high, she actually sews herself to both of them, with a needle and thread. And she's, they're together forever, might I say. So the two singers actually die due to, drug-related issues. And Sally literally lays with them for 5 days while their corpses rot. Now, this is when the addiction demon rocks up and tortures Sally for, 3 days before she decides to free herself from the corpses by essentially sitting up and letting the stitches rip out, once again, in a pretty grotesque manner. So Sally wants Elizabeth to bring John back to the hotel so he can be killed at the hotel and be with Sally forever. So speaking of John, him, Alex, Holden, as well as Scarlett return home. Now Scarlett feels pretty uncomfortable about the whole Holden situation and how they should tell her grandmother about it. And they decide just to keep it a secret, but it's also John's job to bring them both blood to consume. So Sally brings two of Elizabeth's children to her so they can give their blood to her so she can live. But obviously Elizabeth does not want to go with this because of how much she loves her children, but the children want to see her live, so they go through with it. Now Liz has Donovan cremated for Iris. Now Iris ends up essentially rolling in Donovan's ashes, which I thought was pretty weird, then telling Miss Evers to vacuum him up before heading to the roof of the Cortez. Now, I'm not going to lie, during that scene, I was not phasing out, but I just wasn't really paying too much attention. So I wasn't sure if there's an underlying message there. If anyone does know if there was an underlying message, please leave it in the comment section below. I don't know if it was some form of freeing Donovan, if you know what I mean. It might have been something along those lines. But straight after this, Liz and Iris actually head to the locked up secret hallway thing to get Ramona out so she can team up with them to finish Elizabeth off. When they enter though, they see all the dead children, vampire children, that had been locked in there by John and Alex. Now, they didn't know about that, only John and Alex knew. And then they end up running into Ramona while they're trying to escape. Now, to sort of keep themselves alive, they agree to bring her so-called food. So Queenie, a witch from Coven, aka Season 3, if you've not seen that, she's one of these witches, comes to stay at the hotel. Now, they actually decide to use Queenie as this food, I guess you could say. Now, it doesn't go to plan at first, as she uses her, in Coven, she had these abilities where essentially she was a human voodoo doll. If you stabbed her, it stabbed you, you got the wound. So she uses these abilities to defend herself against Ramona. But these abilities don't work against dead people. So when Mr. March stabs her, I think it's through the heart, no, it wasn't through the heart, it was just, through the chest. She actually begins to die, and Ramona jumps in her and begins to feed on her. Now, I'm guessing some people might be mad at the writers for killing off Queenie. You gotta remember, Coven's not really that prominent anymore. Obviously, the season ended, so she was either not gonna appear ever again, or they could just decide to kill her off. Now, Mr. March reveals to Ramona that he wants her to kill Elizabeth as well. So, John returns home. He has some food in the trunk of his car, if you know what I mean, for Alex and Holden. But when he actually goes inside, no one is home. But he finds a key to a room from the Hotel Cortez, so he knows where to go. Now, when John gets to the hotel, it's obviously going to be room 64, he finds Sally, who tells him that Mr. March has his family, and he has to complete the last commandment killing to get them back, which of course is thou shall not murder. So Ramona ends up going to kill Elizabeth, but to keep it short and simple, it doesn't happen, and they somewhat make up. So Elizabeth wants to leave with her son, but on her way out, of the penthouse where she lives. As the elevator comes up and opens, John is in there and shoots Elizabeth multiple times, killing her, and he actually uses her head as the trophy for the commandment killing. Sally randomly pops up and tries to kill John while John and Mr. March are like marveling over their trophies and their achievement that they've just done. And during their periodical dinner that they have, I just call it a periodical dinner because it just happens every now and then, Elizabeth attends for the first time as a ghost. And Mr. March says that he forgives her for turning him in, but when she says she didn't do it, like she honestly did not turn him in, if she wanted him dead, she would have done it herself, Miss Evers confesses to doing so. Now, so she says she wanted to die with Mr. March together so he would be able to know her better and see her for more as a maid and know her more in depth. And she's trying to like explain everything, like almost like a heartfelt confession. But Mr. March just simply tells her to get out and that she is now banished, which in some way means that she's free. She's no longer confined to Mr. March. She's no longer his essential servant, I guess you could say. So to end off the episode, Elizabeth begins to realize how miserable she is going to be now that she is trapped in the hotel forever. We can see her starting to cry and stuff like that. So she realizes, oh my God, shit. Like, that's basically the best way to put it. So overall, I thought this was a decent episode. Donovan got an okay departure, I guess you could say. It wasn't not the best. Could have got a better departure, but yeah, it was okay. The only thing I was a bit about, I wasn't too happy about it. I would have liked the vampire children to have had more of a role. It would have been cool to see them be like a darker version of Elizabeth's children, but treat Ramona as their mother instead. So it's almost like a light side, even though obviously Elizabeth's not essentially good. But, you know, like they got her side and her children, then you got Ramona's side and her like vampire children, I guess you could say. As I said before, I'm not sure what the reaction to Queenie's death will be. Coven is gone, so I don't see why there should be too much uproar about him. So, I think it's fine. And I'm pretty sure next week is the finale. That would only be 12 episodes for this season. And the only other season to have only 12 episodes was season 1. The other seasons from 2, 3, and 4 all had 13. But I'm guessing this is due to the fact that they had really long first two episodes. Like, the first episode was like it was like an hour and a half, which is two episodes essentially, and then the second episode was like an episode and like three quarters almost. So they had a really long first two episodes, so this is probably the reason why they're only having a 12 episode season. So thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, leave any comments on what you thought of this episode and what you think is going to happen next week in the finale. I've got a somewhat basic idea, but I don't want to say too much in case it spoils something, so I just have to wait and see what happens next week for the finale for Hotel. And if you are new around here, make sure to subscribe for more American Horror Story videos, and I will catch you later. Goodbye.